Church's live stream. We hope that, or we are happy that you are joining us today, whether that's through Facebook Live or through Greenbrier Radio on Sunday mornings at 9 a.m.
We want to highlight for you a couple of announcements. One is that we do have a Facebook page and would love for you to check us out every day. There's something new and fresh. There's live music on there. There is devotions for the week and all kinds of good info. Also want you to know that Fresh Air Prayer is still happening outdoors. Every Tuesday at noon, it's a worship experience just for 15 or 20 minutes. And we also have a prayer circle that meets Tuesday mornings at 9 a.m.
This week, our youth is going on a mission trip to Shamadelica. And then on Monday, we are going to help out in Alderson to where they recently had the floods. And we are looking forward to that. And we ask for your prayers for safety and guidance for these next couple of days. And Bev, I understand that you're celebrating a milestone today.
I am turning 50.
I hear two signs of showing age or loss of memory and lack of vision.
Very true. In fact, this morning, just so you know, I'll just go ahead and confess, I forgot my reading glasses that I have to have now. So our dear Tyler ran back to the parsonage because I forgot to bring my reading glasses and he went and rescued the day. So thank you. For my birthday, I got my reading glasses back. We hope that you will join your hearts as we sing together. We're going to sing Spirit Song, and we'd love for you to sing along with us.
We ask that you go ahead and send in your prayer request for today, and we will light the candles at the end of the service.
Please join me in praying for COVID. Dear Lord, we know that right now is a time of uncertainty for so many people. It's a time where we feel maybe scared or afraid of what's next and what's to come. But Lord, we know that you are still in control, and that you bring peace that surpasses all things, and that we don't have to understand everything because you have it in your hands, and that all we need to understand is that you are in control, Father, and that we can trust you with what is to come. We pray for all of the healthcare workers, Lord, that are working to help us overcome this, and we just pray that you would be with all of them and give us all peace in knowing that you hold tomorrow. Amen.
Open your hearts to this musical response to prayer.
Power and comfort of God's hand in mine.
We would love for all the children to gather around and listen to Abby McGilvery share a word for you. And then stay tuned, because there'll be a song with puppets involved to sing along with you.
Good morning, kids. Gather around for children's sermon. So this morning, we're going to be talking about making mistakes. And that's a really hard topic because we all make mistakes, but sometimes we don't really like to admit it. So sometimes when we make mistakes, maybe with a friend, they can get really mad at us. And usually that friendship kind of suffers a little bit. Maybe you don't hang out for a while or they don't talk to you, and it makes us really sad. But on the other hand, when we make mistakes in our life, God is always happy to forgive us. He reaches down and forgives us and tells us it's okay and that we can be better next time. And he always gives us unconditional love that just helps us to want to be better every day. And he never holds a grudge against us or stays mad at us. He just unconditionally loves us. And it's so great that we have a God that loves us through all of our mistakes. And we just want to thank him and praise him for loving us. And we can try to love others the way that he loves us, even through our mistakes. I hope you guys have a great day, and we'll see you next time.
Hi, friends. We're going to sing together a familiar song, but I thought it might be fun to sing it with a few of my friends.
Bah! Moo! Nah!
God is so good! Let's try again, okay? God is so good. God is so good. Wait, who's mooing? We're not mooing, we're singing. Let's try one more time. God is so good.
God is so good.
Yeah. Sheepy, you just kind of got country on us. Let's just try and sing it just regular with our hearts and let the kids join in singing. Please, let's try. Ready? God is so good. God is so good. God is so good. He's so good to me.
As we continue with our favorite hymn series, my hymn today is Great is Thy Faithfulness, and it's kind of our family's theme song. So I asked my mom, since it's my birthday, to read the scripture for us. So let's open our hearts and our ears to God's word.
Our scripture reading for today is from Isaiah chapter 25 and verse 1. O Lord, I will honor and praise your name, for you are my God. You do such wonderful things. You planned them long ago, and now you have accomplished them just as you said. Amen.
Great is thy faithfulness. Tune in.
Thank you.
hymn we are looking into is Great is Thy Faithfulness. And so I have a question for you to think about, and if this is true for you, I'd love for you to raise your hand wherever you are. Would you agree with this statement? I could not have done it without my faith. Or I could not have done whatever happened without my God. If you raised your hand to that statement, that means you just shared a testimony of God's faithfulness. As a child, we grew up singing this song around our family's piano. My mom plays piano and a sister plays piano, and we sang it often. We sing it at all of our children's weddings. We've sung it at our family's funerals, and of course, we sing it when we get together for family reunions or at Christmas time. It's sort of been a theme song for us. What's interesting is I began to look into Great is Thy Faithfulness. It was an interesting story behind it. The fellow who wrote its name is Thomas Obadiah Chisholm. He was born in a poor family in a native of small Kentucky town called Franklin, and he was born in a log cabin. He lacked any formal education, yet he was so interested in education, he became the area's teacher at age 16. He also became the editor of his hometown weekly newspaper. He loved to write. It's said that most of his adult life, he lived very ill. He could not get out of bed, so he did writing from his own bed. So it's pretty fascinating to me that as he went through all these hard knocks, as life sort of stacked up against him, he still wrote a song about God's faithfulness. When I was in my first appointment as a pastor in North Carolina, we were doing this series of different parishioner friends doing their testimony. And a woman in her 30s, it was her turn. And she did the most interesting thing that has always stuck with me. She told the highlights and the joys and the beauty of her story. She talked about how she met her husband and had three boys and became a doctor and got to study medicine, which was her dream. And she kind of highlighted all those positives and amazing parts of her life story. And then she started over again. And she goes, now let me tell you the other side of my story. And around those very same events, she shared the heartache, the loss, the struggle. It was a beautiful testimony of God's faithfulness. Couldn't you and I do the same thing? In your life story, couldn't you tell all the highlights and the things that you, of course, put on Facebook or Instagram that you share in social media, but yet at the same time also share the broken parts? The bottom part of our scripture verse said this, "You do such wonderful things, O God. You planned them long ago, and now you have accomplished them." God is faithful in every part of your story and mine. And I think one thing we need reminded of is that God's faithfulness is not about getting through life without a scrape or a bruise or a wound on your body or a wound in your heart. But in the midst of the grieving parts, in the midst of the hard parts, God shows up for you. What if you tried that on? Could you agree with the statement that God has shown up for me throughout my life story? I want you to kind of finish this sentence the way you might finish it, starting with, God was faithful to me when... For some folks, they may say, God was faithful to me when I lost a child. God was faithful to me when I lost a parent or a loved one. God was faithful to me when I was disappointed, when I was angry, when I was betrayed, when I was depressed or lonely. Certainly, this one may apply. God was faithful to me when I lived through a pandemic that forced me to quarantine. I wonder how you'd finish that sentence, that God has been faithful to me when... Many of you that know me know my story, that God was faithful to me as I married a fella, and 2 years later we divorced, and then, of course, remarried 3 years after we had been separated. Most of you have heard that story unless you're new to Facebook Live or you're new to Greenbrier Radio, but here's the part that is interesting that I thought of this week. We chose at our wedding, when we were young 22-year-olds, to sing Great is Thy Faithfulness. It was kind of our family tradition. And so all of the congregation that was there that celebrated our wedding and all of the wedding party, we all sang together, How Great is Thy Faithfulness, not knowing that 2 years later, everything would change, that we would not be able to continue in our marriage. The sorrow and the loss and the darkness that we walked through the divorce and for 3 years being separated, God still showed up. It reminds me that this song is true, that our God is always true, that even when I am not always faithful to Him, He is faithful to me. May you be reminded that God's faithfulness does not depend on you. As you look through Bible stories of Bible characters that are familiar, you can see how true this is. King David, we know he has a courageous faith story, was an awesome leader in the Bible, yet he was guilty of breaking at least half of God's commandments. How about the fella Elijah? Maybe you're not as familiar with this strong prophet, but Elijah had a breakdown. I want to remind you of the story. He had all this pressure because he was a high-profile prophet of God, and it had gotten to him. So he decided to just hightail it into the wilderness, have a mental and emotional breakdown. Yet God met him there. Elijah was feeling undone. He felt alone and isolated. But do you know how God responded to Elijah? He fed him. He allowed him to rest and to be quiet in the wilderness. And after a time, God answered Elijah's complaints, and he encouraged Elijah with a still, small voice that he was not alone. There's another story, of course, of Paul. He's very famous. He had an awful history. Paul used to be Saul. He was a terror to the early church. He would always allow there to be murders of anyone that was Christian. He had an awful history, yet God was faithful to him, and he became Paul. There's Peter. Peter made impulsive decisions. You just never knew what was going to happen with Peter. He was exciting, and he filled up the room because he was a lot of fun to be around, but his decisions weren't always clear. He betrayed his best friend, Jesus. Aren't you glad that failure doesn't disqualify you from God's love and faithfulness? Aren't you glad that God's faithfulness keeps you in the race, whether you're faithful or you're not? As we look through the hymn's verses, think about how this fella, Thomas Obadiah, what he said about God's faithfulness. He said, God doesn't change. Hallelujah. In the midst of such flux and change and fluid times, isn't it nice to know that your God doesn't change? The hymn writer said, God always forgives. There's new mercies every morning. In other words, you do not wear Him out, even on your worst day. The hymn writer says that God provides. He's enough. He gives you what you need for today and bright hope for tomorrow. The writer says that God cheers you and guides you. He strengthens you. All of these things God continually does, no matter where you are in your life story. Whether you're in a place of feeling faithful and secure and excited about your future, or whether you feel lost, full of doubt, not that interested in faithfully following after God, His faithfulness doesn't change. One more addition that we have just to celebrate my birthday is to have my sister, Brenda, who many of you know, she's led the retreats here for the last couple of few years, and she is a songwriter. And so she wrote a song about God's faithfulness to you. Thank you.
Jeannie Wyatt asks for prayers for her good friend Lynn Tuckwiller, who has surgery this week. Scarlett Kellerman asks for prayers and praise for the life of John Lewis, an American hero in the civil rights movement. Nita Johnson asks for prayers for her friend Pamela, who just finished chemo. Luther Hollingsworth asks for prayers for Luther's cousin, Donna, and George Smith in Virginia Beach. George is in ICU suffering from COVID-19 and is not doing well. Betty Jo Hendrick asks for prayers for her daughter-in-law, Cindy, as she faces cancer surgery on Wednesday. Tina Pence asks for prayers for herself as she goes for surgery on Thursday. Kellen Leaf asks for prayers for her friend Joyce Lovell, who will have heart surgery this week. Jenny McClung has unspoken prayer requests for friends. God knows their names. Mary Humphreys asks for continued prayers for Phyllis Avell. Carolee Christian asks for prayers for her cousin Margaret Giuliani, who started her second round of chemo this week, and also prayers for her cousin Jeannie Lively, whose cancer is back and there are limited options available. Lisa Williams asks for prayers for her daughter Lily Williams, who lost a beloved pet last week. Scarlett Kellerman asks for prayers for the Black Lives Matter movement. And there have been many joys and prayers for Bev's 50th birthday and gratitude for her life.
Let's pray. Lord, we ask that you hear the prayers of your children, and everything that lays heavy on our hearts this morning, God, we just ask for your comfort and for your guidance along life's difficult journey. Lord, we lift up all those requests this morning, and we just pray a special blessing over all of them. Lord, give us comfort and peace during these troubling times, and help us reflect and see that you are faithful through it all. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Bev, that was a beautiful sermon today.
Thank you, Tyler. I am thankful that you joined us. I hope that you'll take a moment to tell somebody near you or your family or a friend about how God has been faithful to you, just as a reminder that God is still at work and that he's still got something new to do. May we leave this place, may we leave this time of live streaming with a song on our hearts and a song on our lips. Amen.
Start to doubt if you exist, and God believes you. Confounded by the evidence, God believes in you. When your chances seem so slim, when your light burns so dim, you swear you don't believe in him. God believes in you. Rise up just to fall again, God believes in you. Deserted by your closest friends, God believes in you. When you're betrayed with a kiss, you turn your cheek to another fist. It does not have to end like this. God believes in you. Everything matters if anything matters at all. Everything matters no matter how big, no matter how small. God believes in you. When you're so ashamed you could die, God believes in you. You can't do right even though you try, God believes in you. Blessed are the ones who grieve, the ones who mourn, the ones who bleed. In sorrow you sow, but in joy you will reap. God believes in you. Blessed are the ones who grieve, the ones who mourn, the ones who bleed. In sorrow you sow, but in joy you will reap. God.
Tuning in and watching Lewisburg United Methodist live stream worship. I'm Rev Bev Colombo, and I want to thank you for the ways that you have continued to give and support the ministries of our church. We miss being with you. We miss gathering physically together. But until we can do that again, we want to continue the ministries of this church. So thank you for your gracious giving. And if you would like an opportunity to give to the ministries of our church, you may do that by mailing a check to P.O. Box 69. You can go on our website and click electronically the give button, or you can come by the church. Our office is open during the week now, and we'd love to see you. Thanks.